I invite you to take a slow, easy, deep breath in. And as we breathe in, we allow our body to relax, to release, to let go of everything that's holding us in a past thought or moment. We can release and let that go. We can enjoy the pleasure of now being safe and serene. This is a good morning. This is a good day. It's just for you. Allow those words in and any doubt out. Feel the goodness of these words as they settle in and take root inside your being. Allow them to grow with the sunshine of this beautiful day, the light from the inner sense of knowing you are okay, you are safe and supported. Peace.
And what beautiful scenery to start our collective worship with. It reminds you just how beautiful the world is.
Good morning, everyone. This week, we're learning about Lent.
The story of Lent. After 40 days and 40 nights of rain, God made a covenant to always be with us. After 40 days and 40 nights on Mount Sinai, Moses received the law, and his face shone for 40 more days. The Israelites wandered in the wilderness, eating manna from heaven for 40 years. Jesus fasted and was tempted for 40 days and 40 nights. And then he began his work of proclaiming liberty to the captives, letting the oppressed go free, healing the sick, lifting up the lowly, suffering, dying, and rising again, so that together we might rejoice, receive, shine, feast, follow. And rise again on Easter morning.
Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. But what is fasting? Let's hear from Father Anthony Messer.
Whenever it comes to Lent, a lot of times we're not excited about it because we don't understand why it is that we torture ourselves with the fasting. A lot of times the honest answer is because we're supposed to, because the church tells us to, which is a good answer. I'm not saying that's bad, but hopefully we can get to the next level. Why do we torture ourselves? Why does the church tell us to fast? What's the difference? What does God care if it's Siami cheese or regular cheese? What does God care if it's veggie burger or hamburger? What does God care? What does God care if I eat at 9 in the morning or 10 in the morning or 11 in the morning? What difference does it make to him? Easy. Don't overthink it. Simply, you fast to make you hungry. Easy. You fast to create a hunger inside of us. No matter how hungry or how much I desire to eat something, if I'm already full, I can't eat it. If I want to put that inside my stomach, no matter how much that it tastes so good to me, if there's all my stomach is already full of stuff, then I can't. If my plate is full of pizza, there's not gonna be room for chicken. If my cup is full of soda, there's not gonna be room for juice. I believe that deep down, Every single human being, especially all of us here, have a desire for something. That's why when I say Lent, no one likes it. When I say Holy Week, no one likes it, but all of us want it. Deep inside of us, there's a desire that we know this is what we want. The goal of fasting is simple. Make you hungry to simplify your life. When you remove those thoughts and those concerns and those emotions and those desires, I promise you, you will see the benefit. The food is just the step one. The food is just the stomach. But the thought is the next step that we need to go. And the emotions is the next step we need to go after that. Is to remove those things and watch how it will increase your focus. God fills as much as we empty. If I had a water bottle, this is what Lent is. If I had a water bottle like this, okay, or a soda bottle, whatever, and it's half full, God will fill the other half. If it's 25% full, God will fill 75%. If it's 90% or empty, if it's 90% empty and it's only 10% full, God will fill 90%. So you choose how much God you want in Lent. If you fast and you empty yourself, the first week will be torture. That's why Lent is not 1 week. Is that in this busy, in this full, you can't get the fullness of God in Lent. You want the fullness of God? Easy. Start taking stuff off your plate. Off of this plate. Off of this plate, and especially off of this plate as well. Lent is a chance for you to see something special. And Lent is a chance for you to experience something special. But in order to get there, we gotta put in a little bit of the work.
You haven't got to fast from food. Pope Francis has lots of fasting ideas. We could fast from hurting words, fast from sadness, from anger, from pessimism, from worries, complaints, pressures,
bitterness,
selfishness, and grudges. And while we're fasting, we can add things to our lives too. There are some great ideas here from Pope Francis, like this first one, fasting from hurting words. We can add kind words into our lives, and we can fast from sadness and be filled with gratitude. Here's a great creative idea, a fasting wheel. Why not pause the video and have a look at it? Maybe even attempt to make one yourself. Use this time now to think about what you might fast from. And can you turn that fast into something that you might add into your own lives? And inside your own heads, ask God for help. And to let it be, you say Amen. And to finish our collective worship today, I'm going to leave you with a song. A song that you're familiar with, and the words appear on the screen so you can sing along too. A perfect song as we enter Lent. In the meantime, work hard, be kind, look after yourselves, and we'll see you real soon.
Lord, if we could, we would fill our hands with all the wonderful things you give us. Then we'd lift them up and give them back to you.
To you, Lord,
I give it to you, Lord,
and
Remember to click subscribe and the notification bell to be kept up to date with our collective worships.